Hi! Hey, it's your man, Arnez J. Excuse me, let me get my smooth voice. Hold on. It's your boy, comedian Arnez J. And you're listening to, you're looking at, and you're hearing about the humormillmag.com. Go to it, see what's up. Oh, you're going to hear some mess.
Mill, and I'm here in Houston, Texas with the one and only Arnez J.
Good evening.
Okay, y'all. I'm just going to put it on out there. Arnez just ripped the stage out here. And so if he looks a little winded, you know, that's exactly why. And if I'm looking a little cockeyed and crazy with my eyeliner running, yeah, I was out there crying. So it was a great show from beginning to end, and I don't know where your stamina comes from.
I don't even know why she said if she, her makeup running, you know good and well, she ain't gonna do no interview with running makeup. You know she went in that bathroom and got toasted up again.
Well,
me, myself, I really don't care. I'm not trying to win a pretty boy competition. No, I'm a performer. That's what I do.
And you performed your behind off tonight. I gotta give it to you. And you do look dapper.
Well, I appreciate it. I mean, a little wrinkled, but you know, we're all right.
You doing what you do?
Tonight, so.
Two sold out shows, mind you.
Two shows. We had a great time. A great time here. Mm-hmm.
That's right. Houston does Arnez right. Mm-hmm.
I will say this about Houston. Audience is beautiful here. And when I say beautiful, I mean beautiful. Mm-hmm. Love it here. Love my Houstonians. Love them.
So you travel all around the country, and, you know, you do sold-out shows back-to-back. How is it that you continue to have the stamina that you do?
You know, I think, you know, you keep yourself in shape, and you stay prayerful. You must stay prayerful, because without God, to me, God is like the motor, the engine of a car. Without the engine, that car ain't going nowhere. And without him, I'm not going anywhere, and I know that. So my car don't start without my engine being there, and God is my engine.
That's right. Well, one of the things that I noticed during your show was you do a lot of real-life anecdotes, and then you'd segue into just hilarious, you know, just raw comedy. How did you think to, you know, put your show together like that? It's not too many comedians that has that, you know, that style.
Well, you have to realize I've been in this business over 19 years. And at some point, you start to, people think you become the comedian overnight, or you've been in it 6-7 years, you now are a comedian. It's a constant job, a constant learning process. Mm-hmm. And I think the way that I'm doing and how I segue my stuff, a lot of times I don't know how I do it. Mm-hmm. It's just something that builds, and it comes to me in a thought pattern, and then I go with it. So this is it's like any other great job, like any other great actor. Mm-hmm. You know, you must practice, do the craft to become great at it.
Mm-hmm. That's right. And let's not forget to mention, when you shoot from the hip and you start in on the audience, oh my goodness.
But you know what, though? I do that in a loving way. I'm not malicious. Mm-hmm. You know, I don't try to hurt anybody's feelings. Mm-hmm. When I do it, I just have fun. Mm-hmm. Like the dude with the afro tonight, that was ridiculous.
That was hilarious.
That was a throwback afro. And we call that, in the old days, they call that the bent back. Because that fro was going back, looked like he just been in the wind all day, and your hair was just going back. Oh my God. Yeah, that was pretty funny though.
Yeah, that was hilarious. That was really hilarious. So if you guys don't have an opportunity,
like a yarmulke, wasn't it?
You know what? You were in violation. Tell us a little bit about the comedy special.
Well, the comedy special, it is what it is. It's an hour special. I want it to be different because I really think that my comedy is different than most people's. Mm-hmm. And I try to hone in on that. You know, a lot of people always want to claim what their comedy is, but I know what my comedy is. I don't think everybody's mind goes differently, but I don't think nobody's mind really goes where mine goes.
Mm, that's for sure.
You know, because something that may be stupid to me, may people may enjoy it. And so you, and a lot of times you don't know why that's happening. You don't know. I shoot my special December 14th in Boston, Massachusetts, at the Wilbur Theater, and that's going to be beautiful. It's about time, you know, and I'm so happy to be doing it. And then, of course, we have a couple of projects that we're hoping are going to grab, you know, but the special, I'm really concentrating on that one because that's coming up pretty quick. And y'all go to RNSJ Comedy and just contact me. Excuse me, and I promise you I will get back to you.
Now, what about, you know, you told us about your Twitter and, you know, your website. Now, what about, I know the hot thing now is people putting together material for their YouTube channels. Is that something that you wanted to explore or thought about exploring?
That's funny you brought that up. That was just brought up to me last week about doing a YouTube channel. And I might possibly do that, but my YouTube, if when I do it, probably won't be as funny. It will be more on the, I wouldn't say intellectual, but more of the life channel, more like real events. Mm-hmm. And I will probably a lot more serious because I do have a heart for that politics. Just like Mitt Romney, I'm going to tell y'all something. It is so important for y'all to vote. If you don't vote, I'm telling you, if Mitt Romney wins, shackles are going to go on sale the next month at Walmart. I'm just letting you know. Oh yeah. We will be retracting. Mm-hmm. You understand what I'm saying? Yeah. I mean, because did you see them when he picked Paul Ryan, and when they was at the, not the delegation, but when he first announced that he's going to be the vice president, all of them had on Dockers. Mm-hmm. I mean, everybody, it looked like a Mormon golf tournament getting ready to start up. I'm just letting you know.
Yeah. Have you been active on the political scene? Have you been doing any?
No, not really, because I Twitter a lot of political things, but as far as in the war zone and in the battle for no one's really. A lot of people don't know that I'm into that, you know. So I don't know. I just enjoy the life cycle. Of who we are. Mm-hmm. When you watch the Democratic convention, if you noticed it, it was amazing because, you know, that's what the real America's about. Mm-hmm. All those nationalities in there, that's what the real America is all about. Mm-hmm. Republican convention, you know, you're probably talking 95% white. I mean, it's just the way it is. Mm-hmm. And we can't not allow the world to go back that way.
That's right.
So,
very good.
It is what it is. It's not Mitt Romney's fault that he is more of the conservative white party, but it ain't my fault that I'm more of the outgoing black party.
Mm-hmm. That's exactly right. From his mouth to your ears. Okay, once again, please tell us how your public can contact you.
Go to RNSJ Comedy. That's it. Just go to RNSJ Comedy, and you'll be able to Twitter me. Huh? There's one right there. And we'll get back to you, I promise you. I love y'all. Want y'all to keep it live. Keep your hearts and your spirits soaring to the top. And remember this. Take the time to say hello to God. Because if you don't take the time to say hello to him, he ain't going to be in your life. He'll be around you, but he won't be in your life. And it's so important. Love you. Bye-bye.
All right, you guys, this is Carla J with Arnez J here at the Houston Improv for the Humor Mill.
Sister.
Take care.
Peace. One love. As they say in Jamaica, talk to you later, boy.
You know, arrivederci.
Arriba de Janeiro. Conconscaro. In Africa. I see you. I will see you tomorrow.
Wait.
Say but boom, say but no. It is not your problem, Dubé. You just call me in the morning. I see you.
Y'all take care.